a light but dramatic day of racing here in Marstrand, and we have our semi-finalists. First up, Ian Williams, progressing through 3-1 against Yann Guichard and Sprintdrift Racing. At times, it felt like the Frenchman had better speed, but Williams with, again, superb match racing, positioning and tactics, able to keep him back to close out the match. Williams bringing his bow up, and Williams committing to above, trying to go over the top, and I think he's got some good acceleration. Williams starting to move over the top of the line of Yann Guichard. And in the final 23 seconds, Williams generates a roll, but he's going to be really early now.
There's the gun, and someone could be over early. Both bows very close there. And we're waiting to find out whether it is a clear recall. Blue flag. That is Ian Williams over the line early and a costly error as he now slows down.
Two teams very much in form came together in the next matchup. David Gilmour up against Taylor Canfield from US One Sailing. Canfield had to use every ounce of his match racing experience to keep David Gilmour back, ultimately closing out that match 3-2. I think that David Gilmour will be on starboard. They are coming up on the gate. We'll see Canfield maybe looking for the cross. I'm not sure he's on lay line either. Now, will David Gilmour look for the roll, or will we see him tack? And they're going to be head-to-head here. Canfield coming in on starboard. David Gilmour trying to stay out of the way. It's all to do here. Both boats now in a drag race to see who will win.
Blue flag penalty. Gilmour gets another penalty.
Next up saw Nicholas Dackhammer, the Swede, the local boy here in Marstrand, up against PJ Posma from Team NL. Dackhammer had the whole of Sweden behind him coming into this match, but Posma, improving every day with every match he sails, came through and comfortably won 2-0.
With the Swedish fans on shore watching, because the race will go to Peter-Jan Posma from the Netherlands, one up.
The final match was the eagerly anticipated all New Zealand derby between Chris Steele and Phil Robertson. Robertson took the first match, but Chris Steele, fighting back with match two, came into the top mark with a real opportunity to strike back. Chris Steele looking to try and dig it on the near side by the castle. It's going to be a little Kiwi dash. Which one of the bridges will win? Will it be north of the bridge, Steele, or south of the bridge, Phil Robertson? Robertson a lot nearer, but Chris Steele's moving a lot faster. And I think Phil Robertson has slightly the better of the bias.
Came right down to the last foot of the finish line, and the race goes to Phil Robertson.
So we have our final four, and it is through to semi-finals and finals. And the only question is who is going to get their hand on the illustrious trophy here in Marstrand.